On his day two of the five-day visit to Indonesia, Malaysia and Singapore, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi today met Indonesian President Joko Widodo in the capital of Jakarta. This is Prime Minister Modi's first official visit to Indonesia and his fourth meeting with President Widodo. After a ceremonial reception for PM Modi at the Indonesian Presidential Palace, the two leaders discussed steps to upgrade the relationships to a comprehensive strategic partnership. Addressing a joint press briefing with Indonesian President, Prime Minister Modi strongly condemned the recent terror attacks on churches in Indonesia, where many innocent people lost their lives. He said India stands resolutely with Indonesia in the fight against terror. Prime Minister Modi also said India-ASEAN partnership is such an important power that can become a guarantee of peace not only in Indo-Pacific region, but also beyond it.
Samudrik padosiyon एवं सामरिक साझेदारों के रूप में हमारी चिंताएं एक समान जैसी हैं। सामुद्रिक मार्गों की सुरक्षा एवं संरक्षा सुनिश्चित करना हमारा कर्तव्य है। यह हमारे आर्थिक हितों की रक्षा के लिए भी आवश्यक है। आज के बदलते हुए इंडो-पैसिफिक क्षेत्र में हमारी विशेष जियोस्ट्रेटेजिक लोकेशन है। हम एक जैसी विकास एवं पर्यावरणीय चुनौतियों का सामना कर रहे हैं। इंडो-पैसिफिक क्षेत्र में सहयोगों के रूप में एक दूसरे की प्रगति एवं संपन्नता में हमारे साझा हित है। और इसलिए हमने इंडो पैसिफिक क्षेत्र के लिए सांझे विजन और सिद्धांतों पर सहमति की है। फ्रेंड्स, भारत की एक्ट ईस्ट पॉलिसी के साथ सागर SAGAR, और जब मैं सागर कहता हूं मतलब है सिक्योरिटी एंड ग्रोथ for all in the region. और सागर का हमारा विजन राष्ट्रपति विदोड़ो की मैरिटाइम फलक्रम पॉलिसी के साथ बहुत ही मेल करता है।
Prime Minister Modi also inaugurated a kite exhibition in the capital of Jakarta. PM Modi also flew kite along with President Joko Widodo. The kite festival is themed on Hindu mythology this year, with images on kites depicting stories from Hindu religious epics like Ramayana and Mahabharata. Earlier today, Prime Minister Modi paid a homage to martyrs of Indonesian freedom struggle at the Kalibata National Heroes Cemetery in the capital of Jakarta. Later in the day, PM Modi will be attending an event organized by the Indian diaspora. In the second leg of his visit, PM Modi will make a brief halt in Malaysia to congratulate the new Malaysian leadership. He will leave for Singapore on 31st of May for a three-day visit, which will be his second official visit to the island's city-state. PM Modi has said the focus of his Singapore visit is to enhance the bilateral partnership. He will also deliver the keynote address at Shangri-La Dialogue on June 1st. Earlier, my colleague Karthike Sharma spoke to head of Indonesia's Economic Forum, Sachin Gopalan. Take a listen.
Joined by Mr. Sachin Gopalan, an author who runs Indonesia Economic Forum, and someone who has studied India, Indonesia culture, economy, and he's a noted authority on it. Sachin, is this trip going to make a difference to India and Indonesia relationship? Is it going to go to the next level?
Well, I think it will, because, you know, it's been a long time in waiting. I've been here 21 years now. And we've been seeing the momentum has been gradually building up. And the unthawing has taken place already a few years ago. So we look at this as a huge opportunity, because if you look at these two countries, India and Indonesia, they are among the largest democracies in the world. And the opportunity to be connected actually exists from the historical roots of India and Indonesia. So there's no reason why this should not culminate into a fruitful relationship into the future, especially if you're looking at now, the world is going digital. Digital transformation is big. This market is known to be a country where digital transformation is going to change the way everything happens here, because the country is very complicated. You know, it's there are three time zones, 16,000 islands. Transportation from one to another is a big challenge. So digital is the way to go forward. Now, who better than India to help Indonesia in the journey of digital transformation? So I see there's a huge opportunity going forward.
But is there a strategic interest also? You know, generally people reduce the relationship to vis-a-vis in opposition to China. Apart from that, are there any other opportunities for the Indian business and the Indonesian business?
I would say, you know, one must look at the cultural context, okay? Nowadays, you look at businesses, you have the hard side of business, which is, you know, you're looking at commodities, you're looking at manufacturing, etc. But if you look at the soft side of how business is done, you go back to the ways of how the origins of India and Indonesia, you know, going back, you know, thousands of years, you find that there is a very strong cultural connect. And I think a lot of people agree that today cultural connect forms a new way of defining a relationship that can take it in a completely different direction. Does India have a cultural connect with very many other countries? Or does Indonesia in turn have? You know, very much the relationships with the trade partners and the business partners are very hard business relations.